And you do it all of the time, but you don't work smart, you're not gonna make it. And it goes without saying that if you don't even work hard, you don't stand a chance. There's a thing as far as working hard, and I don't blame you if I'm the 10 millionth person who's told you in your life you have to work hard. I guarantee your parents have told you that, your parenting coaches have told you that, anytime they ever.
Idea of the Junior Achievers came up this past summer. Wanted to take on a project and do something that was really meaningful for the school as a whole. And what I looked at was some of our discipline data. And as I went through month by month, you saw the same pattern. And when you added all the data or put all the data together, there was definitely a discrepancy between some of our boys and then the rest of the student population in terms of who was receiving these reflection forms. So it was something where I said, okay, well, how can we fix this? What can we do? How can we address this issue? And I didn't want to just say, oh, we need to do staff development on this. While we can't expect any student to go from one spectrum to the other in terms of behavior, what I would imagine most teachers would agree is that when the students connect with you, or when you connect with that student, they will think twice, or they will be more mindful because, you know, you have that relationship. They know that you care about them. They know that you are holding them accountable. And it's not just this constant cycle of being punitive. And then, you know, that becomes the norm for that class or for that student. And then, you know, they become disengaged.
It's
important that you know what our purpose is for this group, our mission for this group. And that is, we've read this before, we want to create a learning environment that promotes hope. What do you look forward to? What are you hopeful about? We want you to be engaged in your learning. Don't just be in class with nothing on your mind. You should be focused in learning, engaged in the process, and then excellence. It's not okay to be average. You want to try and do the best and be your best in everything that you do, whether it's in school or out of school. With your friends, with people you just meet, you always want to put your best foot forward. And then finally, excellence. Excellence is being the best, doing your best. They are here volunteering their time to support all of you. They're worried more about just themselves. They want to contribute and give something back. So that's the message we're actually going to know and hear and see throughout our whole time. Why do you think we started Junior Achievers?
To let boys like me believe in themselves and believe in others.
To provide hope and strength for the young students that we have at Duckett's Lane.
I think it's for other kids that
So we can be role models of the other kids from little kids. So then we can be role models in other schools then. We get to know more of the high school students, so we can know what we do here and to get better for the for middle school and high school. And we also get to know what do we have to do here in elementary school.
The idea of mentorship from the Alpha Achievers really just gives them a chance to see and interact with some boys that have more than likely similar life circumstances. So, you know, when they look at those Alpha Achievers, I want them to see themselves. So these Alpha Achievers are, you know, these boys have 3.0 GPAs, they're applying to colleges, they're doing community service.
When the Alpha Achievers come, I like that when they come and then they talk to us, because it makes me feel better. It makes me feel like I'm not alone and I have people that I could look up to and be like them.
Career, 3.5 years. That's it. So 28, 27, 26
years old. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you know, if you want to do football, go for it, you know. That's, you know, as long as you're happy. But always, you know, have a backup, so to say, if you don't get into football, or, you know, if you decide football isn't for me, you can say go into business, or me, I want to be a video game designer, he wants to be a sports physical trainer. Yeah, you know, both those jobs, they aren't like, say, billions of dollars a year, but, you know, we'll still be happy. That's how you get the nice car and stuff, you know, you have to stay in school and, you know, do your best. Keep up with your grades, because it really only gets harder. You know, I remember back in elementary school it was easy, and then I got into middle school and I was like, I want to go back to elementary school, you know, this is really hard. And then I'm like, ah, it's gonna get better. I get to high school and I'm like, I'm gonna go back to middle school, it's gonna get hard, you know. But you know, you gotta keep up.
So Cameron, what are some goals you have for yourself, or maybe something you've talked about with one of the Alpha Achievers?
Never talk back, follow directions the first time, do everything you're supposed to do.
To get in the NBA, be famous, get good grades in school, and go to college.
Go to a good school, play football, or go to the military or be an engineer.
They said, what do you gotta do to get where you wanna go?
A field trip?
Field trip to UMBC.
And it was the field trip. Yeah, it was.
Well,
I like the basketball game because I never been in a basketball game before. And I also like the food.
Going on the field trip to UMBC. I got to look at a college. I had a good time.
What we did in every session was writing our journals. And I'm a big proponent of being intentional, so after our UMBC field trip, we talked about what it would take to even have an opportunity to get to a place like UMBC. What can you do right now? How can you set yourself up for sixth grade and beyond? So that
another challenge is just, you know, our fifth graders, they're 10 years old, and you know, they don't necessarily see the big picture or what the mission of our junior achievers is. So sometimes, you know, they might take it for granted. Something I start with at every meeting is that this is not an extra recess. This is not, you know, a get out of class free card for 30 minutes every other Wednesday. This is an opportunity for you to learn. This is an opportunity for you to, you know, learn about yourselves and learn about your peers. And it's definitely something where, you know, we need to have that occasional, okay, let's stop. Because right now this looks like a Hoot Club celebration. Mm-hmm. And that's not why we're here.
What do you want to remember? How much money do you want to make?
Let's come back.
To you to do? You're going to be in one of these. Now, how many people would rather make $60,000 instead of $30,000? I'm sure you would. I'm sure you would.
The higher, the better.
Exactly. It's that new page that has today's date on it. I want you to answer the following question. What does it mean to finish strong? What does it mean to finish strong? Has some meaning for you based on the things that you write. Tyler, can you stop, please? Just stop. The expectations have not changed. As far as being leaders and learning from each other, we want the people in the building to look up to you. You have 9 more weeks in elementary school, and you're going to middle school.
Because there are going to be challenges, whether they're in elementary school, middle school, high school, adults. And I think with any challenge, you need to understand that I need to find another way. We can't just give up. You can't just quit. You can't just say, you know what, I don't want to pursue my goal. Or, you know what, that dream, maybe it's not going to work out, and then you become discouraged. So this idea of hope is just something I think that resonates from the time you're a child for the rest of your life. You need to wake up and have something to look forward to.
Thank you to the young men who are honoring here today. You know, good leaders are mentors, and good leaders are mentored. Great leaders are both.
I've learned what I can do in high school to help me get my GPA up and get into a good college. I've seen what college looks like, and I've learned a lot of the different things that go on there. I've heard, seen, and experienced these things thanks to Junior Achievers and the people supporting it. Please allow me to earn this $500 to help me do the many things Junior Achievers has taught me. Thank you for reading my essay.
In the end, my goal, just as I shared with the mission statement, has been to promote hope because there are so many experiences that our boys are going to encounter both in and out of school that send the wrong messages about who they are or what they're capable of.
I use hope when I'm in school because at school I try my best to get my classwork done, and I try to do a good job on my work.
I want to promote engagement and help our students recognize that their education can open up a lot of doors for them, and it is the key to their success as they pursue their goals, whatever they may be.
favorite word is excellence.
Why excellence?
Because I want to do good in school and other outside activities.
At that point, I was actually really happy to be in this program because it kind of made me think more of my future. Because before I was in, I used to think of my future like, this is my future, I'm gonna probably do this and this. But now I think of it as more, like, I want to do this and this and have the opportunity to do that and that. And the reason I wrote some of the stuff in my journal, as in like people, like my skin color or tone, flunked out of school is because recently in this world now, in the modern world, most of those students are doing that and they're not really focusing on their grades anymore. They're focusing on partying and other stuff. And I think that Junior Tutors is a great program for them to be.
There's a saying in the Black community that says, you have to be twice as good as them to get half of what they have. That's why we must strive for excellence rather than settle or be content with average. All of our students deserve the opportunity to live rich and full lives. My hope is that Junior Achievers has instilled some of these guiding principles for our students as they leave our building and move on to middle school.
Which one would you choose?
Hope.
Why would you choose hope?
Because there's never something that you couldn't do, that you can't do. Prove everybody wrong.
I may get in trouble like once or twice, but I mean, it's all part of the process. You make mistakes and you're only human, so I guess I can show people that I'm not just a stupid Black male. I'm a smart, independent Black male.
I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top.
Engagement.
Excellence.
Hope. We are Junior Achievers.